Lupus, or systemic lupus erythematosus, SLE. What is lupus? Lupus is a disorder that affects the skin and joints, often also involves the internal organs, including the heart or kidney, and also organ systems. Lupus is an autoimmune disease, which means that your body's defense system produces antibodies that attack the body's own tissues due to the failure of the mechanisms which maintain self-tolerance. Type 2 hypersensitivity, which produces antibodies against host tissue. And type 3 hypersensitivity, which is caused by the antigen-antibodies complex, is the cause of the tissue injury. Lupus is more common in women. 1 in 15 cases of lupus occurs after the age of 50, and it tends to have different severity of symptoms in people over 50 years old. Symptoms. The symptoms of lupus are joint pain, malar rash, fatigue, fever, weight loss, headaches, swelling of lymph glands, swelling of feet, Raynaud's phenomenon, changes of skin color in fingers or toes into blue, white, red during cold conditions, mouth ulcers, hair loss, breathing difficulty and shortness of breath or pain when breathing in, photosensitivity, pleuritis, blood problems such as anemia, leukopenia, or thrombocytopenia, problem with the heart such as pericarditis, myocarditis, and Lippmann-Sack endocarditis. Kidney problems, with diffuse proliferative glomerulonephritis as the commonest one. Outlook. People with lupus may have some period of time before their symptoms get worse and they fall ill. It means that lupus has turned from an inactive into a flare state. It is a variable and unpredictable condition and may even be life-threatening for people whose vital organs are affected. Unfortunately, it's difficult to precisely predict how lupus will affect you. Most people with lupus don't have more serious complications, but your doctor needs to be wary of them. The complications include 1. Antiphospholipid antibody syndrome. This happens when the antibodies attack the proteins that are bound to the phospholipid. It causes arterial and venous thrombosis. 2. Fibromyalgia. A widespread bone and muscle pain, along with fatigue and sleep disorder. Check out our video for further information. 3. Osteonecrosis, the collapse of bones due to the decrease of blood flow to bone cells. 4. Infection, because of the weakening of the immune system. 5. Other autoimmune diseases, such as Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Diagnosis. You will need to have regular checkups with your doctor to get diagnosed for early signs of lupus. The earlier the diagnosis, the lesser the complications. The laboratory investigations for SLE include 1. Antinuclear antibody, ANA. This is the hallmark of the disease, as it is positive in virtually all patients with SLE in the course of their disease. ANA is detected by indirect immunofluorescence. The ANA can be grouped into four categories. A. Antibodies to double-stranded DNA, or anti-dsDNA that is specific for SLE. B. Antibodies to non-histone proteins, or snRNP proteins attached to RNA. C. Antibodies to histones, characteristics of drug-induced SLE. D. Antibodies to nucleolar antigens. 2. Anti-Rho antibody test. 3. Complement C3 and C5 level test, as their levels go down when lupus is more active. 4. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate, ESR, and C-reactive protein test to indicate inflammation inside the body. 5. Urinalysis and its sediments may reveal hematuria, pyuria, proteinuria, and cellular casts. 6. Urine protein to creatinine ratio with serum creatinine can give insight into the kidney's condition. 7. Complete blood count and differential may reveal the blood problems. Treatment. Until now, there is no cure for lupus yet, but rest assured, as you have two good news. First, some of the symptoms can be relieved accordingly. The photosensitivity and subsequent malar butterfly rash can be prevented by using sunscreen. preferably SPF 50 or greater. The aforementioned Raynaud's phenomenon can be prevented by using gloves and socks in a cold condition. The second good news is that this disease is very often treatable, showing meaningful responses to a number of different types of drugs, particularly when treatment is done in the early stages. A rheumatologist may advise you specialized treatment with hydroxychloroquine, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or NSAIDs, steroid tablets, creams or injections, conventional disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, DMARDs, drugs to control high blood pressure and high cholesterol, immunosuppressants such as methotrexate, azathioprine, mycophenolate, cyclophosphamide, biological therapies such as rituximab, cyclosporine, belimumab. Besides rheumatologists, other practitioners may also be necessary to consult, especially if there are indeed further complications. Pregnancy and lupus. While women with lupus can still have a baby, it is best to discuss with your doctor before proceeding to get pregnant to alter your lupus treatment if needed. Always plan a pregnancy whenever possible at a time when lupus is already inactive for at least 6 months.